take this kiss upon the brow, and in parting from you now, thus much let me avow, you are not wrong, who deem that my days have been a dream. Yet if hope has flown away in a night or in a day, in a vision or in none, is it therefore the less gone? All that we see or seem is but a dream within a dream.
Tonight. Don't worry, I got something for you. So today at the bank, an old lady asked me if I could check her balance, so I pushed her over. You know, I tell my girlfriend, she draws her eyebrows too high. She seems surprised. What do you call a guy with a rubber toe? Roberto. Roberto. Get it? There it is.
There it is.
I know funny.
Thank you.
It's Mike. Just got off the phone to the client. Couldn't have gone better. We're through to the next round. Call me back, okay? Hey, Will, it's Mike. The client loved your ideas and wants to have your babies. Call me. Say I really appreciate the amazing work you've put into this pitch so far. So, call me when you get this, okay?
Have a good excuse for not being here right now.
Sorry I'm late.
What's gotten into you lately, Will?
Bourbon? Rocks?
You don't even notice me anymore. You've changed ever since you just started to check out. Will, the office called me today. It sounded pretty urgent. I hope you're not messing things up at work, Will. You really don't need that. You've got some serious bills to pay, and I'm not gonna pay them for you. Will, put that thing down.
Sorry.
Face up to your responsibilities, Will. Face up to your responsibilities, Will. You can't just keep going around like you don't have any. I'd like to settle down someday. Maybe raise a family. You're not a kid anymore, Will. You've got to start to take things a bit more seriously. Do you doubt that?
Do you doubt that?
Are you even listening to me?
Sorry, what?
Thank you.
not sure this is working out anymore. I think maybe we should take a break for a while, okay? I'm sorry.
Okay? What's wrong? Has someone been hurt?
Hey, Will, it's Mike. I'm worried about you, buddy. Listen, I'm anxious to get you briefed on this pitch round. Call me back as soon as you hear this, okay? Thanks, buddy.
Will?
Yes.
Hello, I'm Dr. Hope.
Nice to meet you.
Now, what seems to be the problem?
I can't sleep. I'm having these dreams that I can't explain. I don't know if they're real or not. I keep having a dream about a girl. I'm losing my mind.
I may have something that can help you. I'm going to prescribe you these. They'll help you sort out your sleeping issues. Make sure you follow the instructions very carefully. They can have very strong side effects. So let me know immediately if that happens, Will, okay?
I will.
Here's my card.
Thanks.
Hey, Will, it's Mike. Are you sick or something? The client called and said we're in a great position, but we're not out of the woods yet. A lot riding on this one, buddy. Do you doubt that?
My finest work. Do you doubt that? Do you doubt that?
Do you doubt that? Will, it's Mike. Dude, I'm seriously concerned. We're running out of time. Call me back.
Thank you. Pretty messed up, Will. Although I'm sure the pills and the booze aren't helping.
Well, the good news is I finally found the girl of my dreams.
Well, that's great, Will.
The only problem is I don't know her name, where she's from, or if she even exists.
Well, it sounds like you're off to a great start.
Let me ask you a question. Where do you think we go to when we go to sleep?
I don't know.
So my ex-wife walks into a bar.
Not tonight, Steve. I've been thinking, what if cyberspace is just a copy of outer space? I mean, the universe is made up of code, right? Just a bunch of ones and zeros. If you can have a relationship with someone online, then it's entirely feasible. You could have a relationship with someone in the dream world, right? It's the same thing.
I think you just have way too much time on your hands, Will.
I don't know if she's a ghost. I don't know if she lives in some other dimension. All I know is our minds are connected in some way. And if she is real, then I have to find her.
Be careful what you wish for, Will.
You sure you're gonna be okay, bro?
I'll be fine.
Maybe you should lay off the cheese for a while.
Will, it's Mike. The pitch is tomorrow. All I can say is I hope you've been working on something magical at home.
Excuse me? I'm looking for the girl in this photo. Do you recognize her?
Yes, I do. I'm sad to say, she is no longer alive. She died a while back. Car accident. Great shame. She was a wonderful young woman. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Monarch. That was her last name. Monarch.
I stand amid the roar of a surf-tormented shore, and I hold within my hand grains of the golden sand. How few, yet how they creep through my fingers to the deep while I weep. Oh God, can I not grasp them with a tighter clasp? Oh God, can I not save one from the pitiless wave? Is all that we said or seem but a dream within a dream.
Will, it's Mike. As you can imagine, the meeting did not go well. You let us all down, Will. You and I are done, buddy. We are done.
Please, stop! Up against the wall! Up against the wall!
Feet back!
Give me your left hand. Right hand. All right, let's go! So, Mr. Edgar, what brings you all the way out here?
I was looking for a woman.
Does this woman have a name?
Well, she did. Ophelia Monarch.
Yep, the Monarch accident. That was a big blow to a small town like this. The parents never got over it. They died soon thereafter.
Some said the loss of two daughters was just too much to bear.
Two daughters?
Yeah, they were twin sisters. Their car plunged over a bridge into the river. It was very nasty. Odessa, the twin in the picture here, she died instantly. Ophelia, the other sister, she was in a coma for years. I don't know whatever happened to her.
So technically, she could still be alive?
Technically, yes, but it's been many years. Perhaps I could run a hospital check in the morning.
Would you? Seriously?
I could do that, but we gotta lock you up for the night. Let's go. There's a patient at St. John's Hospital in a coma, registered under the name Ophelia Monarch. Here's the phone number of the doctor in charge of the ward.
Thank you, sir.
Don't let me catch you trashing my town again, okay?
No, sir. Thank you again, sir.
Let's go. Get out of here.
This is St. John's Hospital. Can I help you?
Hello? This is William Edgar. I'd like to speak to Dr. Marcellus, please.
Can I ask what it's regarding?
It's regarding a patient of his, Ophelia Monarch.
Just a moment.
Hello, Mr. Edgar?
Yes?
Mr. Edgar, are you a member of the family?
No.
Mr. Edgar, it's most bizarre that you're calling today.
Why is that?
Well, you see, no one's visited here in years.
And?
Well, I'm sorry to have to tell you that we've made the tough decision to terminate the life support system.
Oh.
I'm sorry, but we did everything we could.
Well, can I at least see her?
Oh, you're gonna have to hurry, I'm afraid.
Why is that?
The procedure is set for 9:30 a.m. today.
Taxi!
Yeah, where to, bud?
St. John's Hospital. Please hurry.
You got it. Hop in. Here you are, bud. St. John's Hospital.
Please.
You got it.
No! Where's St. John's Hospital?
That way. 2 miles. Yeah.
Wait, please. Just one moment alone with her. I need to say goodbye. Please.
5 minutes.
Take this kiss upon the brow, and in parting from you now, thus much let me avow, you are not wrong, who deem that my days have been a dream.
Help!
Yet if hope has flown away in a night or in a day, in a vision or in none, is it therefore the less gone?
Help!
All that we see or seem is but a dream within a dream.